Welcome to RPR. In this video, we'll discuss about how to automate login page using Microsoft Power Automate. So here I will just add or create a new flow as login page and click on create. So in most of the web-based applications or Windows-based applications, any applications always have login page. Whenever we want to automate, it's required expertise to be added within our automation phase. Otherwise, we might leak data or we might lose end of sharing our credentials with the end user. So I will suggest you best practices as well. So be available from start to end of this video so that you'll be able to understand how we can automate end-to-end using Microsoft Power Automate. Now, as of now, we are using this web page to be automating. This web page is very simple enough. We are just using username and password and clicking on login tab. Because this will use dummy username and password, then also we will add a secured enough way so that we can use it with proper security assets. Now, to perform this, we are using Launch Chrome as a browser, and from here we will add the link. So rather than using direct link, I would suggest to use URL so that we can have this link available everywhere. So I'm just using URL as a text. I will specify default value as this page. So whenever I will use this link or URL variable, it will open this page. Now I will drag and drop Chrome, and here I will specify this URL. Window should be open and maximized, and here if you want, you can add advanced properties as well. Let's say you want to clear cache cookies, we can do it, because in some of the websites or applications require to clear their cache and cookies. So we'll specify here, variable produce is browser. So let me save this. To perform the login, we need two parameters. One is username and second is password. So here you can see we have two options. One with the form filling, which is on Windows, window based. And when we are doing the browser automations, we can select here. So if you are using any applications which is a desktop based, probably you can use this options rather than using this one. So now it will auto select this one. For UI elements, we'll just click on this UI elements and specify the locations. So here I will just left click with the mouse plus control tab so that we can specify it here. Rather than using direct password, I will prefer to use the variable. So here I will create input as a variable, and rather than using text, I would suggest to use thing as mark sensitive. So here we'll use as a username as mark sensitive. So specify, let me use as default value. Because we are marking as sensitive, so you will see the difference. So here I'll specify second variable, that is username. Perfect. Now the warning will be resolved. Again, we'll drag and drop one more field where we will add UI elements for password. Now again, I want to use with variable where we can store our password. Again, we'll select here mark as sensitive, and default value I will use, because this is a dummy login page where we can use any value. So I'm just keeping as test is a default value, which we can map it here with password field. So now this is done. Next one, I want to perform click operation. click on web page, and here we'll again use the control plus left key, and here we are done with the clicking options as well. If you want to extract some of the informations, now once we are done with the login, we will see some data is available within the page. If you want to extract that data, we are using some get text type of activity. So let's use OCR here. So I want to capture the complete detail. So here I will just specify extract text with the OCR. I will just drag and drop here. We'll select any of these OCR, maybe Windows OCR engine test racks or OCR engine variable if we have any other OCR screen. If we want to capture the screen, we will just select the screen, foreground window or image or desk, anything will be fine. And this will save into OCR text variable. Definitely, I will cover detailed video about this in any other video. Let's try to understand this login page first. Once we are done, we will just showcase this message, OCR message on display message box. While selecting this here with OCR text and set done. After that, I want to close the browser. So I'll just specify close browser activity here. And again, it will select the instance as browser. Once I will save and run this code, we'll have the complete detail available. Because we are using extract text with the OCR, we might get the menu, that means header and footers of this complete screen. Let's see. Now it launched the browser, it will enter the detail and do the login, and it will extract the details. Our main message is this one. So here we have this main message available, but it captured the complete screen, which this can see. So here is, this will have the browser detail as well, but our main message is here, which we can extract it easily or export it easily in some other text. And this also captured this footer sections as well. So that is not having big deal here. Our main motto to extract the details, and after the once we'll click on OK, this will close. So this is how we can automate our login page using Microsoft Power Automate. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.